video answering the question I get asked the most, and that is, Ashley, how do you balance being in nursing school while also being a mom, being a wife, having a house to take care of, being a planner babe, being a fitness coach? How do you do all the things? All right, so how do you balance all the things? My answer may actually surprise you. Honestly, I don't try to strive for balance. Because here's the thing, if we think of balancing life, that means that every area of our life gets the exact same amount of time, attention, and effort. And honestly, regardless of whether you're in nursing school or not, I don't think every area of our lives require the same amount of time, energy, and effort. For example, I don't need to put in the same time with my husband that I do with nursing school. Does that mean that I don't care about him or I don't love him? Absolutely not. That just means our marriage doesn't, like, we don't have to be up each other's butts all the time. Honestly, if we are, we argue like brother and sisters. Like, we argue over petty things. Like, I think this is yellow and he thinks it's green and we have a full-blown battle about it. So when I spend that much time with him, we start to get a little petty with each other. Versus with my son, I have to spend more time with him than I do with my husband. He's a six-year-old, and kids view love as how much time that you spend with him. So I'm spending more time with him than I am with my husband. On another track, taking care of myself, exercising every day, making sure that I'm eating healthy and stuff. Honestly, you guys, honestly, let's throw out the whole time excuse here. Taking care of yourself doesn't take that much time. I literally do a 20-minute workout 6 days a week. 20 friggin' minutes. Nursing school takes a lot longer than 20 minutes every day. So striving for balance, I personally believe, is unrealistic. It's not gonna happen. I'm not gonna have a perfectly balanced life. However, what I do is I understand that I am currently in a season where nursing school takes up most of my time, energy, and effort. I also have my priorities set, and I think this is really important for you to do, even if you're already in nursing school, but I think definitely if you haven't started nursing school yet, to do that, to do this, to set your priorities, to know what it is you're going to say yes to and what you're going to say no to. So let me give you some examples. Here's my yeses. These are the things that I will say yes to above all else. Myself, taking care of Ashley, nursing school. My son, my husband, that's it. Everything else, if I get to it, I get to it. But if I don't, it's not that big of a deal because I've hit my priorities. And I told you guys those four priorities that I have. That doesn't mean that one is more important than the other or that I like one more than the other or I want to spend more time in one more than the other, if that makes sense. But those are my four priorities. I will say yes to those and no to everything else, and I'm okay with that. So what's not on my priority list? Doing a bunch of things for other people. Spending a lot of time with friends. It's not that I don't love my friends, because I do, and I would like to be able to spend more time with them, but right now in this season, that's not realistic because my family is more important to me, and if I haven't spent time this entire week with my son or my husband, and a friend messages me and asks me to go out to eat, it's a no. It's an absolutely not. And it's not that I'm being mean or I don't like that friend or I don't want to spend time with him. My family is important to me. And taking care of them comes before everything else. So I think it's really important for us to set our priorities going into nursing school and then also to understand that it's a season. It's not forever, you guys. Nursing school is 2 years of your life, or if you're going for BSN or even if you're in medical school. You know, it's not the rest of our lives. I mean, yeah, the rest of our lives is going to be consumed with nursing, obviously, because that's what we're going into. That's the career we have chosen. But the actual schooling part of it is 2 to 4 years or whatever. Whatever you're going for. Let's just say 2 years here. It's 2 years, you know? And I think I have actually had a lot of pushback from friends and from a few family members. They have made very rude, negative comments to me about how much time I'm spending into nursing school. And here's the thing. Number one, I'm not mad at them for that. They're not in nursing school. They've never done it. They've never walked through this. They don't understand how truly hard it is. The only people that's going to understand that is your classmates and alumni nurses. Nurses that have done this, have been through it, have graduated, they'll tell you the exact same thing. Nobody else is going to understand it. So one, I don't get mad at them whenever I get negative comments. And two, the other thing I do is kind of evaluate that relationship. Yeah, I know that sounds a little scary, but honestly, if someone is bringing a lot of negativity into my life, I'm not going to accept that. We're not going to be best buds, you know? I'm not going to be spending a lot of time and effort with you because you're just dragging me down, you know? And if someone doesn't respect the fact that I am trying to better my life, I'm trying to better my son's life, my husband's life, our family's lives, then I'm sorry. Like, that's not important to me. Like, I don't care that it makes someone else mad that I'm trying to better our lives. So that's kind of my take on it. Like, my house is a disaster during the semesters. Right now, currently, I'm in between spring and summer semester. We have a little bit of a break here, so my house is semi-clean because I had time to clean it. But during the semester, like, our house is a disaster. It's not disgusting or dirty. It's just crap is everywhere. We live out of laundry baskets, like, just clutter and just a mess. And that's okay, because I know that I will get through this semester, which is the main thing. And once I'm through it, I can clean it. I can get everything put back to where it goes. So I don't stress about those kind of things. You know, like, it's not balanced by any means. And I'm not perfect at it. And I fail at this all the time. I mess up all the time. And something else I think is important, too. Even while in nursing school, you're going to have other things that require your attention for a short period of time that takes away from nursing school. For example, over the winter months, my son, he's getting so much better at this. I'm hoping that he freaking grows out of it, but he gets croup a couple of times a year in the winter months. So when he's sick, even though I'm in nursing school and I have to study, I have to give my attention to my child who needs me, who is sick, who needs his mama right now. So I focus on him. And sometimes that means I have to stay up a little bit later to study, or I have to get up earlier than everybody else to study, or I work out at a different time during the day, or maybe I don't get to spend time tonight with my husband because I need to study. It's just kind of like a go with the flow kind of thing. Like, second day, first semester, second day, our instructors told us, like, you need to be able to go with the flow. We're going to teach you the concepts, but you need to be dead set on the way of doing it. For example, like with a sterile field, sterile to sterile is sterile, but sterile to anything else is not. Here's your basic concepts, but you can do a sterile field in a freaking muddy pit. You need to be flexible. You need to understand that situations change, that life changes, that things happen, but you're just going to remain sterile. This is all you got to do is just keep it sterile. All right? Be flexible in your approach. And don't be like so like dead set on it has to be this way. And I think that's a really good, important thing to learn, not only just to be a nurse, but also with life. Like, it's all right. These are my priorities. And sometimes one trumps the other, or, you know, whatever. I've never had a freaking balanced life. Holy cow, I'm looking back and it's like, no way. So I don't strive for balance. You know, I'm going to say, I encourage you to understand that you're in a season right now and it's temporary, but if you obviously disagree with me, like, girl, do your thing, or guy, if you're a guy watching this, like, do your thing. Don't let me stop you, but try not to get so caught up on being perfectly balanced. I just think it's unrealistic and it's not going to happen, so that's my opinion. So I hope that gave you guys some direction, some insight. I know it probably wasn't what you were wanting to hear, or you probably watched this video thinking I was going to have some kind of magic trick for how to be perfectly balanced in your life, and unfortunately, I don't. If you're looking for that, I am not the person to be following, let me tell you that. But yeah, that's just my advice, is just to understand you're in a temporary season right now, and it'll be over soon. You'll graduate, you'll become a nurse, you'll get a job, and then you'll get to put your focus into other things and rekindle some relationships with friends or family or whatever, you know, is your priorities then. But that's my take on it. So don't forget to go do all the things that YouTubers harass you to do in each video. Subscribe, like, comment. There's a bell, I think, on there somewhere that you're supposed to hit. I have an Instagram. Like, I don't know, all the things. Go do all the things, but more importantly, enjoy the season that you're in, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I will see you in the next video.